¡No hay nadie aquí! ¡Esta también está vacía! ¡Encontré a uno de ellos!
The dead guys looked like soldiers in one of those Central American guerrilla armies. Pirates with a manifesto. Psychos with a dream. That sort of bullshit. This was where Marcello was supposed to be sleeping. He'd barely come down to this deck. Passos had the name of the bar where I was drinking my life away. I should have put things together then, instead of waiting for Da Silva to walk me through it real slow. I had a way of making any space my own. The boat was well appointed. Daphne's ship was always stocked. The radio. Maybe I could send out an SOS.
Disparos en la corriente inferior. Vete a ver qué pasa. Asegúrate de que los burros no derrochen municiones con los tripulantes. Todos los demás siguen buscando.
It certainly wasn't the first time I'd woken up with a hangover, long after a party had turned sour. The need to get out of the boat's hull and onto the upper deck as soon as possible was countered by the probability of running into another hijacker. I had to move carefully. Sucking oxygen from the room. I didn't care if I got shot the second I got out of there. I needed one more gulp of fresh air before I died. It was like the need for a wake-up whiskey after a two-day bender. How to shut off the fuel feeds. I shut down one engine, but it didn't make much difference. Now the boat could get back to smelling like suntan oil, stale margaritas, and greed.
Vamos aquí! Bosque cubierto!
So this was the famous Panama Canal. We could have gone to the moon while I was passed out and I wouldn't have noticed.
Hey!
While I'd been dead to the world, some of my shipmates were just plain dead. Where had they taken them? It was a different scene than the one I'd stumbled away from. Where was everyone? I still didn't know what the hell happened. I didn't like to think what was behind the door. Booze, coke, pills. You could get whatever party favor you wanted on this vessel. The guys up ahead weren't dealing with passengers like the rest of them. Maybe I should have realized then that this was no ordinary kidnap job. Something on the boat had attracted the sharks. Whatever they were looking for appeared to be gone.
Hijo de puta, aquí no hay nada!
They didn't help with my sea legs, but they sure as shit felt good.
Miguel, venid para acá!
There was something firing these guys other than good old-fashioned socialist zeal. What were they looking for? It didn't make sense. Why would they leave the jewels and rip open the walls? It didn't occur to me just what the other cargo on board could be. I was on a ghost ship in a ghost canal. The whole thing creeped me the hell out. The pirates wouldn't get everything. to save some valuables.
¡Anda, anda! ¡Está abierto!
Something on the bridge. I checked every other inch of the boat. I spotted Passos and Marcelo. If I'd known back then that they'd been up to no good while I was fighting my way through a band of violent paramilitaries and a worse hangover, I might not have wanted to get over to them so bad.
Hey, Passos!
At the time, I hadn't thought too much about this. I hadn't thought too much about anything. Now I remember it. It didn't seem quite so kosher.
What about, what's her name? Daphne.
Do whatever you think is best.
I think it's best we try to go find her.
Yeah, okay. Let's go.
See? I didn't think Passos was a bad guy. He didn't need to try to save this woman or the crew.
Through here.
Using that building to get across the canal.
Come on! We're gonna get her, let's get her!
There was some equipment in the truck next to me. It'd be a shame to see it go to waste.
Top floor!
Cross up top. Find on a boat full of drunks and bullshit artists, I'd been the cabaret act. Shooting whatever came in front of me was easier than coming to terms with that reality.
You
madre!
Private welcoming party. Still in danger. Americans had a long and checkered history of involvement in Panama. This was my sorry chapter, for what it's worth. Jesus Christ.
Fuck, man. This is brutal. I didn't think things would be like this.
I should have jumped in that goddamn canal myself and swum my way back to New York.
What do you think you were really doing in Panama?
I was drinking.
People died. Innocent people. Who do you think robbed you?
I don't know. I was told it was People who dislike Daphne Bernstein. Something about an unpleasant divorce.
Her ex-husband worked on Wall Street. Do you think he has easy access to Panamanian death squads?
Guess I didn't really think about it.
You were smuggling something, weren't you?
No, no, no. I mean, I didn't realize it at the time. I didn't think too much about it, but yes, Marcelo did drive off with something. I don't know what. I didn't see him until we got to Brazil a week or so later.
I think it was money. I think Marcelo and Victor have a friendly banker there in Panama. Your little cruise was to deliver the cash to him because there it's easier to launder.
I thought the Broncos were rich.
Rodrigo's rich. The other two, they live well, but they don't have real money. Victor's campaigns were always financed by his brother. That is the way among certain rich families there. The eldest brother is the king. You know, he gets everything. The other two, not so much.
And now Rodrigo's dead.
Exactly. And Marcelo, too. It's an awful tragedy for Victor, huh? A man running on a law and order ticket, you know, whose brothers have both been killed in such terrible circumstances. A true patriot.
What about Marcelo?
Marcelo was an idiot. Were this true, I certainly don't believe he could possibly have known about it. But I do believe some other scheme, you know, some other bullshit. Whatever that cash was, Victor could have talked him into something. I don't know yet.
And Passos?
Well, Passos is a bum ex-cop. He failed in America. Failed in São Paulo. He was surrounded by more money and more poverty than his tiny little head can handle. You think guys like that can't be bought?
No, but if...
But nothing. He's probably not a bad guy. He's just a man caught in the crossfire of a very rich family.
What about me?
You. You're the fall guy. The American. Running around, acting like the action hero. Killing lots of people. You're a stroke of genius.
That ain't how it is.
You were an angry ex-cop. You were sitting in a bar with a history of violence and a history of a bad temper. You were perfect.
Me and Passos went to the academy together.
Did you?
I don't fucking know.
Okay, let's take a drive, Max. You want to do some good? Want to get yourself killed in a good cause? Then I need you to check something out for me.
Like what?
That incident at the favela today. Now, some of my officers say a bus drove off some captives.
They did, I saw it.
But no captives were ever booked.
They probably handed them off to the paramilitary death squads, the,
Caixa Preto?
Right.
Who did?
I don't know, the cops. The other cops, the cops who shoot on sight.
The UFE.
Right.
Max, you see that building there?
Imperial Palace Hotel?
Yeah, that's what it says. People go in there, in large groups, under armed guard. But it isn't a police station, and no one comes out of there.
Why don't you just go in and bust the joint, get a warrant?
I'm only a cop, Max.
So you keep saying. Time to find out what was going on here. I didn't fancy booking myself in the presidential suite, so went looking for the basement. I wasn't too excited about the acoustics in this place. A couple of gunshots would sound like I'd walked in here with a goddamn marching band. It wasn't pretty, but I guess none of what was about to happen was gonna be. It was the question I kept on asking myself. How could I have been so blind? I was convinced the Broncos had gotten the wrong man for the job, but maybe De Silva was right. I was the stooge. The bad joke everybody got but me.
Pesado pra caralho, tá cheio de chuva. Ah, comeu um boi.
Either those guys wheeled their trash out on stretchers, or something was seriously wrong here. Ufe. Was there anything they didn't have a grubby hand in? A few days earlier, I'd have called it a coincidence, but I'd written off too many of those already. Hotel was a five-star bona fide shithole. I needed to find out why guests were checking in by the busload and checking out by the bag load. Maybe the service would be better upstairs.
Tá fazendo nada, tá fazendo tudo sozinho.
Como é que eu não tô pegando nada, rapaz? Tô trabalhando aqui, ficando de olho e escutando você reclamar.
Ó.
Olha o quê? Para com essa viadagem, para de reclamar, de saco cheio.
Porra!
Meu filho da porra!
Thank you.
Silva and I had the same fan club. I knew enough and he knew too much. We'd both become targets. I knew this thing was bigger than me, bigger than the Broncos, but I only had a glimpse of the whole picture, like looking in a mirror and for an instant seeing what everyone else sees, a bad caricature of a better man. Faye, that deal at the favela was getting dirtier by the minute. Those bastards were clearly in bed with the Crush of Prado. Now we just had to find out why. Starting with a bit of bedtime reading for Mr. Da Silva. When you've lived the kind of life I've lived, reality comes at you through a different lens. But nothing could have prepared me for what was on the other side of that door. I had to get those poor bastards out of there.
Get them out of here. Go. Go. Wait. I said get... Serrano.
Serrano. He looked pathetic. A man defeated. I walked away and left him to his own personal nightmare. Whatever hell this was Da Silva had sent me into, I knew I had to put an end to it. I had no choice but to push on. I didn't understand everything, and I never would, but I understood enough. Sometimes a complicated problem is best tackled with a simple solution. This was hell on Earth. De Silva was no fool. I'd have driven on off into the sunset too if I were him. But I was in too far now. It looked like Victor had won the sympathy vote, found his universal connection to the people, triumph out of tragedy. Part of me couldn't help thinking that had been his plan all along. There it was, the soundtrack to my life. And, for a few seconds, came harmony. Finally.
How much do you want?
What have you been doing?
I am a doctor. I help people.
What have you been doing here?
It's easy for you. Listen, I know people. They will kill you. I can help you. Trust me. Please, please.
What have you been doing?
I have a lot of money. Look, look. Lots of money. I do important research, please!
Caralho! Caralho!
Espera, espera, eu posso explicar tudo! Tudinho! Não, não! Por favor! Pelo amor de Deus! Por favor, não me mata! Não, não! Pelo amor de Deus!
E aí, doutor?
For all Serrano owed me, he'd paid enough. For now, I had bigger debts to call in. Even I could guess what Demo Lisao meant. That building was condemned in more ways than one. They had a fucking arsenal in here. It was time to bring this little hellhole to the ground, so I decided to put some of their C4 to good use. Seen some dark shit in my time, but this was something else. These vermin had gone into a place where life was cheap and found a way to get rich off it. I just wanted to finish this and get far away from here. But then, true to form, more of the rats came out of their holes. Thank you. least my visitors have been kind enough to leave the gate open. It was time to see what VIP treatment awaited me on the penthouse floor. The time I'd bought had been going real cheap. If I was gonna plant the rest of those explosives, I had to do it now. That was the last of the explosives. I just hoped it was enough to bring down the building and all the evil in it.
Vai, vai, rápido, rápido, vai!
Who wants to take a shot? You see what this is? Come on, anybody? Wanna be a hero? I got nothing to lose, let's do it!
Que porra que tá acontecendo aqui?
Senhor Neves!
What the fuck is your problem, man?
My problem? My problem? Wanna know what my problem is? You're turning humans into glue! That's what my fucking problem is!
I don't know what you're talking about, American. All I know is what I hear about you. You bodyguard for the Brancos. They are all dead. You help the poor. Today, many of them dead. You are a proper American hero.
At least I fucking tried.
Well done with your effort. The whole city is grateful. The great American savior of the poor.
That's right.
You think you made any difference? You think stopping this legitimate business venture is helping anyone?
Legitimate? You're stealing people's organs!
We pay for everything! We have the record!
Oh, so people can sell their livers, their hearts, their eyeballs? You're insane, you sick fuck!
We kept people safe in the city! Decent people! Safe! I know a lot of powerful people.
Well, your powerful people aren't gonna help you out of this one, buddy.